it's quite easy to spoof emails, sending so it looks like you're coming from a trusted domain. Thankfully, the email world has several protocols in place that help you stop spoofers and phishers. Today, let's look at DMARC. DMARC, or Domain-Based Message Authentication Reporting and Conformance, yes, it's a lot, is an email authentication policy and reporting protocol that tells mail servers what to do if an email message fails SPF and DKIM. Now, these two records are required for DMARC, but they've also been required by most large mailbox providers like Gmail, Yahoo, and Outlook for a while now. SPF provides a list of IP addresses you've authorized to send on your behalf. DKIM is a DNS record that holds a public key. Mail servers can check against the public key when receiving emails to confirm the email wasn't changed in transit. So where does DMARC come in? Well, untrusted senders may try to spoof emails to look like they're coming from you. A spoofer's IP address will not be included in your SPF record list, so the message will fail SPF. They also won't be able to pass DKIM because the spoofer doesn't have access to the domain's private key to generate a valid DKIM signature. DMARC tells mail servers what to do when both SPF and DKIM fail. You can choose between one of three policies. None, which merely notes the infraction but doesn't change its deliverability. Quarantine, which often places the message in the spam folder. And reject, which hard bounces the email. Now, should you just set DMARC to reject? Not necessarily, and here's why. It's possible several vendors send email on your behalf. If one of them isn't passing SPF and DKIM, and you set your policy to reject, your emails won't make it to inboxes. So while it's best practice to use quarantine or reject, you should only do it once you know your messages are delivering and fully passing DMARC. We recommend three steps. First, test your emails with your policy set to none. Send an email from all the applications and services your domain uses. Confirm that the messages are delivered to the inbox and that the headers show DMARC passing. Second, enable reporting. You could include a reporting email address to receive notifications about DMARC failures, which gives you visibility as you tighten your policy. Finally, enforce stricter policies. Set your policy to quarantine and continue monitoring. Quarantine often results in subtle deliverability issues. Legitimate but broken senders may keep sending, unaware their mail is landing in spam. Once you're confident you've covered all your bases, you can change that policy to reject. Just continue monitoring to make sure you don't have any deliverability issues. The DMARC protocol has a few other parts you may want to know about. We've written several in-depth guides explaining more about DMARC policies, which I've linked below if you have more questions. A DMARC record builds trust with mailbox providers, and it protects you from being spoofed, so win-win. I hope this was a big help, and as always, happy sending.